Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to make this delicious maple soy salmon meal prep. It is less than 5 ingredients and is so super easy. You probably already have the ingredients at home and it makes the perfect weeknight dish. So make sure you keep watching if you want to know how to make it.
So the first thing we're going to do is make our beautiful marinade for the salmon. So grab yourself a large bowl and add 3 tablespoons of soy sauce. I always make sure that I use organic as soy is one of the highest GMO foods in the world. Or you can also use coconut aminos. If you're avoiding soy, you can usually find this in the health food section and it's made from fermented coconut and it tastes really similar to soy. Then to add a little kick to this marinade, you can add some hot sauce. So you can either use sriracha sauce for this or I'm using Frank's hot sauce, which has a really nice kick to it and it has no preservatives and super clean ingredients. Sriracha tends to have preservatives added, so that's why I really like this sauce. Plus it's not too spicy for my preference, so make sure you taste and adjust. And now to sweeten things up, I like to add some maple syrup. So I add about 3 tablespoons of this, but again, taste and adjust to your liking. You can also use honey or rice malt syrup if you prefer, but maple syrup definitely has the best flavor. Make sure you choose pure 100% Canadian maple syrup as this has the best caramelly sweetness. Then for extra flavor, I love adding garlic. So for me, the more garlic, the better. But if you have 1 clove of garlic smashed, then that's great. And I like to put that into the marinade as well as one final thing. But you can also use garlic powder if you like, or omit if you have a fructose intolerance. And finally, you can add your beautiful salmon. I'm using Atlantic salmon with the skin on, but you can also have skin off. It's much cheaper to purchase the skin on and I think it tastes better. So that's why I'm adding mine there. I also love it when it gets a bit of crunch in the oven. Make sure you cover every surface of that salmon with that gorgeous marinade and then you can marinate it for about 30 minutes at least or overnight to let the flavors really develop and soak into that salmon. Make sure you turn it every now and then as well. So while the salmon is marinating, I love preparing the vegetables, so you can use whatever veggies or greens that you like, and I'm using Brussels sprouts today, which is delicious. Roasted really simply, so I've just cored and halved the Brussels sprouts, spread them out onto a tray in a single layer, and I'm seasoning it with some olive oil. This one that I'm using is delicious, and it has a ginger and lemongrass infused flavor, really high quality and beautiful. And then I just sprinkle some salt and pepper to taste on top, and that's all you do. And then I just pop the tray into the preheated oven whilst I prepare the salmon. So as you can see, the salmon has soaked up most of the marinade, and now all we do is line up the salmon fillets skin side down onto a baking tray that's lined with a reusable baking mat. I also like to push the little garlic bits into the salmon fillet for even more flavor. Then pop the salmon tray into the oven for about 8 to 10 minutes. Then we can do one more extra step to make this recipe even more delicious. So there is quite a bit of marinade left over from the salmon. So all I like to do is heat a pan on medium-high heat and add that marinade to the pan until it thickens into a glaze. This takes about 4 to 5 minutes. It's really quick and it's definitely worth it. This glaze is so delicious and perfect on top of that salmon. Then turn the pan off the heat where it will thicken even more as it cools. So to make this into a balanced meal, I also like adding a healthy carb sauce, and today my carb sauce of choice is some organic quinoa. I'm using white quinoa, so I like to measure that out into the 8 portion servings. And just heat that over a high heat with some water, bring it to a boil, and then let it simmer for about 10 to 12 minutes, depending on how much quinoa you've used. Super simple, one of my favorites. Another favorite carb sauce of mine would be brown rice. To make it even lower in carbs though, without affecting the flavor, I also like to use this hack of adding some cauliflower rice. Now, this is just cauliflower florets blended in a food processor into little rice shapes, or I like to buy the pre-frozen cauliflower rice to save time and mess. I love having cauliflower rice on hand, frozen at all times, so I can add it to meals whenever I need to add fiber and nutrients, to bulk it up, and to keep me feeling fuller for longer. So to season it, I decided to add some curry powder. I really like how it has added turmeric, which is full of antioxidants and also helps to boost your immunity. So I just stir that through along with some salt and pepper, of course, and it's ready to serve. So this meal is so good for entertaining. I guarantee that your friends and family are going to love it. Any weeknight or weekday or weekend treat. It's just so versatile for so many occasions. I like to decorate it back into the pan where we cook the glaze, taking out the glaze first, of course, and then I pour the glaze on top of the salmon. And anything that's left over can be poured onto the Brussels sprouts or whatever vegetables you've chosen. I also like to add some fresh herbs on top, and obviously coriander is an Asian herb and that goes great with this type of meal. You can then portion any leftovers into meal prep containers. So I start with the carb sauce, just laying that across the bottom. And then I place the salmon and the veggies on top. Then making sure to let that all cool before I pop it into the refrigerator, where it can keep really well for about 3 to 4 days. You can also freeze it for about 3 months, and it's great to have on hand whenever you need a delicious high protein meal prep. You just defrost it the night before that you're planning to eat it. Again, I also like to add more coriander because I'm obsessed with coriander. I know some people are born hating the herb. If you're one of those people, let me know and like what you would like to use to substitute coriander instead. You can also add some toasted sesame seeds on top for even more protein and flavor. But yeah, this is my favorite way to have salmon right now. It is so ridiculously simple, and I can't believe how much flavor this one meal has because it's also so incredibly healthy. It just has everything you need: healthiness, protein packed, flavorsome, good amount of carbs, lots of veggies, and it's so incredibly satisfying.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you try this recipe at home and let me know in the comments below. If you do, I'd love to hear your thoughts. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you want to see more meal prep ideas. Thanks so much again. Bye.